Good evening, everybody. Thank you for watching. Thank you for clicking on this non-clickbaity thumbnail. Tonight, I have become a Reddit search bot, specifically attuned to filter out bullshit from the subreddit Today I Learned, and only deliver you the most distilled, interesting, unknown, surprising, awesome facts. 100% facts. Let's begin. Well, good evening. Good evening, guys. Good. Record video. Good, good. This is a cool one to start off with. Here we go. And I'm gonna try to incorporate keyboard sounds as much as I can. Today I learned President Herbert Hoover and First Lady Lou Henry Hoover were both fluent in Chinese and would speak it to each other in the White House to prevent eavesdropping. Learn Chinese. And now for you Cantonese or Mandarin speakers out there, is there such a language as Chinese, or is that just an oversimplification? Learn Chinese, okay. To prevent eavesdropping. Okay. And maybe at the end I'll show you guys my running list of wisdom. They learned to fight illegal logging on their land. An indigenous community of 9,000 members in Guyana built a drone by watching DIY videos the illegal activities and report footage to the Guyanese authorities. The authorities learn to build a drone. Although my brother just got a drone, and he owns his own dock building business down here in Florida. And he wanted to, you know, try to get hip with the times, and also just have an excuse to buy a really cool toy. But he pulled all the stops and got like the $1,000 version. And this drone, I almost broke it when I first blew it. It's just so sophisticated. It's also weird just to look at your town, because it goes up like 600 feet in the air, and I live in a relatively small town, so I grew up here since I was about 7-8 years old, and looking at the town that I knew by walking, and street I knew by walking, the river I knew by boating, the local neighborhood I knew by bike riding, in the town I knew by driving, was, it was one of those experiences of meaning, because it kind of synthesized my whole view of my town from all those different first-person perspectives. It lifted up and gave me like a map from a third-person perspective, almost third-person perspective. It was really, really cool. So I could almost kind of fit all my experiences inside that. Today I learned that the Dutch East India Company was the most valuable company in human history, with it being worth almost 8 times as much as Apple is today. National corporation founded in 1602 from a government-backed consolidation of several rival Dutch trading companies. It was originally established as a chartered company to trade with India and Indianized Southeast Asian countries. When the Dutch government granted it a 21-year monopoly on the spice trade. Wow, the spice trade. Called the VOC in Dutch. Are you Danish? Forgive me for this. I don't even want to try to pronounce it. Verenigde Oostindische Compagnie. Looks like champagne. Compagnie. compagne. Or verine ost indice compagne in modern spelling, abbreviated to V-O-C. V-O-C. V-O-C was an early multinational corporation in its modern sense. In the early 1600s.
Edit this plane out and get a drink of water. I'll be right back for the drink.
Yes, my good girl. Well, I'm wearing a little hat. I like your hat. What are you doing? You guys know Marno ASMR. I love how he does. Well, I love a lot of what he does. Mostly, I love how in tune with the zeitgeist. Zeitgeist is a really useful word, meaning the, and it means the spirit or mood. Spirit or mood. Spirit. Of a historical time, and you could just tell he knows. He's just very perceptive about with what creates ASMR and pushing the boundaries and making creative and interesting. Today I learned, which is what this video is supposed to be. In the early 1600s, by widely issuing bonds and shares of stock to the general public, the VOC became the world's first formally listed. Went defunct in 1799. Wow, they traded spice, silk, porcelain, metals, livestock, tea, grains. And you guys, a lot of you are liking my tea episode, so I think I might do another version of very specific history of particular goods, such as spices or metals or the shipbuilding industry, or sugar cane, or coffee, or cocoa. You get the point. So today I learned that the Roman Catholic Church stated in 1950 that there is no intrinsic conflict between Christianity and Darwin's theory of evolution. Today I learned that the cone snail, C-O-N-E-S-N-A-I-L, is considered one of the most venomous animals on Earth. Their specialized teeth work like a hypodermic needle, even piercing a wetsuit. The venom is being used create a painkiller that is 1,000 times more powerful than morphine, yet less addictive. Wow. That's cool. Okay, now I don't know if this is true, but cited on Wikipedia. Today I learned that on his travels through the Arctic, naturalist George Steller described a mysterious creature known as the Danish sea ape. While this has since perplexed scientists, that's why I've never heard of the naturalist George Steller. Obvious joke. His academic record was not very stellar. Ooh, this is interesting. Today I learned the British are often referred to as don't try to make jokes off the cuff. Don't quit your day job. Got it. So today I learned the British are often referred to as limey because of their army's use of lime to prevent scurvy when at sea. The use of citrus was initially a close guarded military secret, as it gave them the ability to remain at sea, and the British are known to be quite seaworthy . Did not know that. Today I learned during World War II, the Nazis fell for a plot masterminded by James Bond, author Ian Fleming. To pass off a dead tramp as an officer carrying secret documents. To convince the Germans to divert troops from Italy, from Sicily, ahead of the successful Allied invasion of the island. And the chess master came to teach them. That makes me think of two things. One is that chess is an infinitely interesting game because it's so complex. It's so simple, yet its simplicity much get the best, most articulated version of whatever it is you're trying to learn. So I guess those with a lot of money, if I had a lot of money, I guess I would be trying to hire the most intelligent people to teach me stuff. I think that would be fun. An experiment to build a castle using only medieval tools began. And 21 years later, they're more than halfway finished. That's cool. Let's see if we can show you guys that. Oh my goodness, my stomach. This is a 6-minute video. I'm going to double speed it twice. Speed it up twice as fast. Because I really love this. Okay. And I'm going to show you here. Let's go.
Edit this. Alright, let's sync it back up here.
Alright, so I guess we are back. And I'm doing this in the morning. And my stomach has not had breakfast. So I'm going to read a couple more and then leave you guys out to try. This one I like. Today I learned that when the Danes, bring up the Wikipedia page for this. When the Danes living under Prussian rule were prohibited from raising the Danish flag, they literally bred a pig to look like the flag, and they called it the Danish protest. Here's an image. That is too funny. So that actually makes me want to look up the Danish Japanese flag. So I guess maybe if you're looking at the pig from overhead, let's see, Danish protest pig. Oh wait, I love the feature that you can right-click and search with Google. Let's say images. Let's see if we can find an overhead. Okay. This one, I think, is very, very important. Today I learned that Shinrin-yoku, meaning forest bathing, is considered a form of nature therapy. In Japan, which has positive effects on mental and nervous well-being, consists of essentially taking long walks in the forest. That's brilliant. The slogan of the revolver Colt, like Colt 45, before it was a liquor store beverage, used to be God created men. Colt made them equal. That's funny. Alright guys, my stomach is protesting loudly. So as much as I really want to continue, but I have to listen to nature. Speaking of that. One last little thought I'm going to leave you with is the apparent increase in fonts, in text fonts, and bear with me here. You know, I never realized, I guess I could do a, because my phone isn't recording the audio, so I guess I could do a very intimate roleplay video. Probably should very soon, because I like those hand movements. Okay. But, so I've been thinking that because we're so immersed in digital culture, that we're lacking an analog, a human touch. The fact that everything is digitized nowadays, it full steam into the digital age, and now we're kind of swinging back the other way, back into a desire. Especially if I see it more than once or twice, I usually have a document that I copy and paste your video suggestions. So you, if you have a video suggestion, or even a general direction you think I should take the channel in, I want you to let me know, because it is seriously invaluable. I love living by the maxim that you have a lot to offer me, if only based on the life experience of yourself that it would be impossible for me to have had. So, I love listening to you guys and your perspectives, and I just want you to know that you're appreciated. So, I'm getting more and more used to talking into my phone lens, because I know it's reaching you, and you ultimately are looking at a computer screen, but you know I'm talking.